The Book of Jasher Prose Form edited by Alan Lewis Silva. By Yasher Jasher. Podcast 16 of 22. Chapter 61. And it came to pass at that time Pharaoh king of Egypt commanded all his people to make for him a strong palace in Egypt. And he also commanded the sons of Jacob to assist the Egyptians in the building, and the Egyptians made a beautiful and elegant palace for a royal habitation, and he dwelt therein and he renewed his government and he reigned securely. And Zebulun the son of Jacob died in that year, that is the 72nd year of the going down of the Israelites to Egypt, and Zebulun died 114 years old, and was put into a coffin and given into the hands of his children. And in the 75th year died his brother Simeon, he was 120 years old at his death, and he was also put into a coffin and given into the hands of his children. And Zepho, the son of Eliphaz the son of Esau, captain of the host to King Anges of Dinhaba, was still daily enticing Anges to prepare for battle in order to fight against the sons of Jacob in Egypt. And Anges was unwilling to do this thing, for his servants had related to him all the might of the sons of Jacob, what they had done unto them in their battle with the children of Esau. And Zepho was in those days daily enticing Anges to fight against the sons of Jacob in those days. And after some time Anges hearkened to the Zepho's words and consented to fight against the sons of Jacob in Egypt, and Anges got all his people in order, a people numerous as the sand upon the seashore, and he formed his resolution to go to Egypt to wage battle. And amongst the servants of Anges was a youth of 15 years old, Balaam son of Beor was his name, and the youth was very wise and understood the art of witchcraft. And Anges said unto Balaam, Conjure for us, I pray thee, with the witchcraft, that we may know who will prevail in this battle to which we are now proceeding. And Balaam ordered that they should bring him wax, and he made thereof the likeness of chariots and horsemen representing the army of Anges and the army of Egypt, and he put them in the cunningly prepared waters that he had for that purpose, and he took in his hand the boughs of myrtle trees, and he exercised his cunning, and he joined them over the water, and there appeared unto him in the water the images resembling the hosts of Anges falling before the images resembling the Egyptians and the sons of Jacob. And Balaam told this thing to Anges, and Anges despaired and did not arm himself to go down to Egypt to wage battle, and he remained in his city. And when Zepho, the son of Eliphaz, saw that Anges despaired of going forth to battle with the Egyptians, Zepho fled from King Anges of Africa, and he went and came unto Chittim. And all the people of Chittim received him with great honor, and they hired him to fight their battles all the days. And Zepho became exceedingly rich in those days, and the troops of the king of Africa still spread themselves in those days, and the children of Chittim assembled and went to Mount Kuptizia on account of the troops of King Anges of Africa, who were advancing upon them. And it came to pass that Zepho lost a young heifer and went to seek it, and he heard it lowing round about the mountain. And Zepho went and looked, and behold there was a large cave at the bottom of the mountain, and there was a great stone there at the entrance of the cave. And Zepho split the stone and he came unto the cave and looked, and behold a large animal was devouring the ox, from the middle upward it resembled a man, and from the middle downward it resembled an animal, and Zepho rose up against the animal and slew it with his sword. And the inhabitants of Chittim heard of this thing, and they rejoiced exceedingly, and they said, What shall we do unto this man who has slain this animal that devoured our cattle? And they all assembled and they agreed to dedicate one day of the year to him, and they called the name thereof Zepho after his name, and year after year they brought unto him on that day drink offerings, and they brought him gifts. At that time Jania, the daughter of Uzu wife of King Anges, fell ill, and her illness was heavily felt by Anges and his officers. And Anges said unto his wise men, What shall I do to Jania and how shall I heal her from her illness? And his wise men said unto him, Because the air of our country is not like the air of the land of Chittim, and our water is not like their water, for this reason therefore the queen has fallen ill. For through the change of air and water she fell ill, and also because in her country she drank only the water which came from Perma, which her ancestors had brought up with aqueducts. And Anges commanded his servants, and they brought unto him in vessels from the waters of Perma belonging to Chittim, And they weighed those waters with all the waters of the land of Africa and found those waters to be lighter than the waters of Africa. And Anjas saw this thing and he commanded all his officers to assemble the hewers of stone in thousands and tens of thousands, and they hewed stones without number, and the builders came and they built an exceedingly strong aqueduct, and in this way they conveyed the spring of water from the land of Chittim unto Africa, and those waters were for Queen Jania and used for all her concerns, to drink from and to bake, wash and bathe therewith, and also to water therewith all seed from which food can be obtained, and all fruit of the ground. And the king commanded that they should bring from the soil of Chittim in large ships, and they also brought stones to build therewith, and the builders built palaces for Queen Jania, and the queen was healed from her illness. At the revolution of the year the troops of Africa continued coming to the land of Chittim to plunder as usual, and Zepho son of Eliphaz heard their report, and he gave orders concerning them and he fought against them, and they fled before him, and he delivered the land of Chittim from them. And the children of Chittim saw the valor of Zepho, and the children of Chittim resolved to make Zepho king over them, and he became king over them. And whilst he reigned they went to subdue the children of Tubal and all the surrounding islands. And their king Zepho went at their head and they made war with Tubal and the islands, and they subdued them, and when they returned from the battle they renewed his government for him, and they built for him a very large palace as royal habitation and seat, and they made a large throne for him, and Zepho reigned over the whole land of Chittim and over the land of Italia for 50 years. Chapter 62. In that year, being the 79th year of the Israelites going down to Egypt, Reuben died, the son of Jacob, in the land of Egypt. Reuben was at his death 125 years old, and they put him into a coffin and he was given into the hands of his children. In the 80th year his brother Dan died. He was 120 years old at his death, and he was also put into a coffin and given into the hands of his children. That year King Chusham of Edom died, and after him reigned Hadad, the son of Bedad, for 35 years. In the 81st year Issachar, the son of Jacob, died in Egypt, and Issachar was 122 years old at his death, and he was put into a coffin in Egypt and given into the hands of his children. And in the 82nd year died his brother Asher. He was 123 years old at his death, and he was placed in a coffin in Egypt and given into the hands of his children. And in the 83rd year Gad died. He was 125 years old at his death, and he was put into a coffin in Egypt and given into the hands of his children. And it came to pass in the 84th year, that is the 5th year of the reign of Hadad, son of King Bedad of Edom, that Hadad assembled all the children of Esau, and he got his whole army in readiness, about 400,000 men, and he directed his way to the land of Moab, and he went to fight against Moab and to make them tributary to him. And the children of Moab heard this thing and were very much frightened, and they sent a request to the children of Midian asking to assist them in fighting Hadad, son of King Bedad of Edom. And Hadad came unto the land of Moab, and Moab and the children of Midian went out to meet him, and they placed themselves in battle array against him in the field of Moab. And Hadad fought with Moab, and there fell of the children of Moab and the children of Midian many slain ones, about 200,000 men. And the battle was very severe upon Moab. And when the children of Moab saw that the battle was sore upon them, they weakened their hands and turned their backs, and left the children of Midian to carry on the battle. And the children of Midian knew not the intentions of Moab, but they strengthened themselves in battle and fought with Hadad and all his host, and all Midian fell before him. And Hadad smote all Midian with a heavy smiting, and he slew them with the edge of the sword, he left none remaining of those who came to assist Moab. And when all the children of Midian had perished in battle, and the children of Moab had escaped, Hadad made all Moab at that time tributary to him. And they came under his hand, and they gave a yearly tax as it was ordered, and Hadad turned and went back to his land. And at the revolution of the year, when the rest of the people of Midian that were in the land heard that all their brethren had fallen in battle against Hadad for the sake of Moab, because the children of Moab had turned their backs in battle and had left the fighting to Midian, Then five of the princes of Midian resolved with the rest of their brethren, who remained in their land, to fight against Moab to avenge the cause of their brethren. And the children of Midian sent to all their brethren, the children of the east, and all their brethren, all the children of Keturah, to come and assist Midian to fight against Moab. And the children of Moab heard this thing, and they were greatly afraid that all the children of the east had assembled together against them for battle, and they, the children of Moab, sent a message to the land of Edom, to Hadad the son of Bedad, saying, Come now unto us and assist us and we will smite Midian, for they all assembled together and have come against us with all their brethren, the children of the east, to wage battle, to avenge the cause of Midian that fell in battle. And Hadad, son of Bedad, king of Edom, went forth with his whole army and went to the land of Moab to fight against Midian, and Midian and the children of the east fought against Moab in the field of Moab, and the battle was very fierce between them. And Hadad smote all the children of Midian and the children of the east with the edge of the sword, and Hadad at that time delivered Moab from the hand of Midian, and those that remained of Midian. And the children of the east fled before Hadad and his army, and Hadad pursued them into their land, and smote them with a very heavy slaughter, and the slain fell on the road. And Hadad delivered Moab from the hand of Midian, for all the children of Midian had fallen by the edge of the sword, and Hadad turned and went back to his land. And from that day forth the children of Midian hated the children of Moab, because they had fallen in battle for their sake, and there was a great and mighty enmity between them all the days. And all that were found of Midian on the road of the land of Moab perished by the sword of Moab, and all that were found of Moab on the road of the land of Midian perished by the sword of Midian, thus did Midian unto Moab and Moab unto Midian for many days. And it came to pass at that time that Judah, the son of Jacob, died in Egypt, in the 86th year of Jacob going down to Egypt, and Judah was 129 years old at his death, and they embalmed him and put him into a coffin and he was given into the hands of his children. And in the 89th year Naphtali died, he was 132 years old, and he was put into a coffin and given into the hands of his children. And it came to pass in the 91st year of the Israelites going down to Egypt, that is in the 30th year of the reign of Zepho, the son of Eliphaz son of Esau, in his reign over the children of Chittim, that the children of Africa came upon the children of Chittim to plunder them as usual, although they had not come upon them for 13 years. And they came to them in that year, and Zepho, the son of Eliphaz, went out to them with some of his men and smote them desperately, and the troops of Africa fled from before Zepho and the slain fell before him, and Zepho and his men pursued them, going on and smiting them until near the borders of Africa. And King Anges of Africa heard what Zepho had done, and it vexed him exceedingly, and Anges was afraid of Zepho all the days. Chapter 63. And in the 93rd year Levi, the son of Jacob, died in Egypt, and at his death Levi was 137 years old, and they put him into a coffin and he was given into the hands of his children. And it came to pass after the death of Levi, when all Egypt saw that the sons of Jacob, the brethren of Joseph, were dead, that all the Egyptians began to afflict the children of Jacob and to embitter their lives from that day unto the day of their going forth from Egypt, and they took from their hands all the vineyards and fields which Joseph had given unto them, and all the elegant houses in which the people of Israel lived, and all the fat of Egypt. The Egyptians took all from the sons of Jacob in those days. And the hand of all Egypt became more grievous in those days against the children of Israel, and the Egyptians injured the Israelites until the children of Israel were wearied of their lives on account of the Egyptians. And it came to pass in those days, in the 102nd year of Israel's going down to Egypt, that Pharaoh king of Egypt died, and Melol his son reigned in his stead, and all the mighty men of Egypt and the whole generation that knew Joseph and his brethren died in those days. And another generation rose up in their stead, which had not known the sons of Jacob and all the good which they had done to them, and had not seen all their might in Egypt. Therefore, all Egypt began from that day forth to embitter the lives of the sons of Jacob and to afflict them with all manner of hard labor, because they had not known their ancestors who had delivered them in the days of the famine. And this was also from the Lord for the children of Israel, to benefit them in their latter days, in order that all the children of Israel might know the Lord their God, and to know the signs and mighty wonders which the Lord would do in Egypt on account of his people Israel, so that the children of Israel might fear Yahweh of their ancestors and walk in all his ways, they and their seed after them all the days. Melal was 20 years old when he began to reign, and he reigned 94 years, and all Egypt called his name Pharaoh after the name of his father, as it was their custom to do to every king who reigned over them in Egypt. At that time all the troops of King Anges of Africa went forth to spread along the land of Chittim as usual for plunder. And Zepho, the son of Eliphaz son of Esau, heard their report, and he went forth to meet them with his army and fought them there on the road. And Zepho smote the troops of the king of Africa with the edge of the sword, and left none remaining of them, not even one returned to his master in Africa. And Anges heard of what Zepho the son of Eliphaz had done to all his troops, that he had destroyed them. And Anges assembled all his troops, all the men of the land of Africa, a people numerous like the sand by the seashore. And Anges sent a message to his brother Lucus, saying, Come to me with all thy men and help me to smite Zepho and all the children of Chittim, who destroyed my men. And Lucus came with his whole army, a very great force, to assist his brother Anges in fighting Zepho and the children of Chittim. And Zepho and the children of Chittim heard this thing, and they were much frightened and a great terror fell upon their hearts. And Zepho also sent a letter to the land of Edom to Hadad, the son of King Bedad of Edom, and to all the children of Esau, saying, I have heard that King Anges of Africa is coming to us with his brother for battle against us, and we are greatly afraid of him, for his army is very great, particularly as he comes against us together with his brother and his army likewise. Now therefore, you should also come with me and help me, and we will fight together against Anges and his brother Lucus, and you will save us out of their hands, but if not, know ye that we shall all die. And the children of Esau sent a letter to the children of Chittim and to Zepho their king, saying, We cannot fight against Anges and his people, for a covenant of peace has been made between us many years ago, from the days of Bela the first king, and from the days of Joseph, king of Egypt, the son of Jacob, with whom we fought on the other side of Jordan when he buried his father. And when Zepho heard the words of his brethren, the children of Esau, he refrained from them, and Zepho was greatly afraid of Anges. And Anges and his brother Lucus arrayed all their forces, about 800,000 men, against the children of Chittim. And all the children of Chittim said unto Zepho, Pray for us to the God of thy ancestors, peradventure he may deliver us from the hand of Anges and his army, for we have heard that he is a great God and that he delivers all who trust in him. Zepho heard their words, and Zepho sought the Lord and said, Lord, the God of Abraham and Isaac my ancestors, this day I know that thou art a true God and that all the gods of the nations are vain and useless. Remember now this day unto me thy covenant with Abraham our father, which our ancestors related unto us, and do graciously with me this day for the sake of Abraham and Isaac our fathers, and save me and the children of Chittim from the hand of the king of Africa who comes against us for battle. And the Lord hearkened to the voice of Zepho, and he had regard for him on account of Abraham and Isaac, and the Lord delivered Zepho and the children of Chittim from the hand of Anges and his people. And Zepho fought King Anges of Africa, and all his people on that day, and the Lord gave all the people of Anges into the hands of the children of Chittim. And the battle was severe upon Anges, and Zepho smote all the men of Anges and his brother Lucus with the edge of the sword. There fell from them until the evening of that day about 400,000 men. And when Anges saw that all his men perished, he sent a letter to all the inhabitants of Africa to come to him to assist him in the battle, and he wrote in the letter, saying, All who are found in Africa let them come unto me from 10 years old and upward. Let them all come unto me, and behold, if he comes not he shall die, and all that he has with his whole household, the king shall take. And all the men of fighting age of the inhabitants of Africa were terrified at the words of Anges, and there went out of the cities about 300,000 men and boys, from 10 years upward, and they came to Anges. And at the end of 10 days Anges renewed the battle against Zepho and the children of Chittim, and the battle was very great and strong between them. And from Anges and Lucas' army, Zepho sent many of the wounded unto his own land to become slaves, about 2,000 men, and Sosiphtar the captain of the host of Anges fell in that battle. And when Sosiphtar had fallen, the African troops turned their backs to flee, and they fled, and Anges and his brother Lucas were with them. And Zepho and the children of Chittim pursued them, and they smote them still heavily on the road, about 200 men, and they pursued Ashdrubal, the son of Anges, who had fled with his father, and they smote 20 of his men in the road, and Ashdrubal escaped from the children of Chittim, and they did not slay him. And Anges and his brother Lucas fled with the rest of their men, and they escaped and came into Africa with terror and consternation, and Anges feared all the days lest Zepho, the son of Eliphaz, should go to war against him.